Hi everyone, my name is Michelle, and in today's ZBrush tutorial, I'll be showing you how to import an SVG file and ZBrush will automatically convert it into a 3D model. Then I'm going to show you how to save it as a tool so that you can reuse it in any new projects in the future. So let's get started. Press comma to close the light box and then go to Z plugin and then go to text 3D and vector shapes. Click on it and go to new SVG and then logo SVG or whatever file, whatever SVG file you intend to use, and then click open. Then once it's loaded, click and drag. And at the moment it is a 2.5D document, so click on edit to turn it into a 3D document. And once you turn it into a 3D document, your brush will be activated and your cam view will appear. With your model loaded, you can orbit around your model by clicking and dragging on the cam view dummy head. Or alternatively, click anywhere on a gray area to orbit the model. Let's turn on the polyframe to see how the model is constructed. The model is constructed by geometric shapes joined together with shapes and points. What you see here are the shapes or face that form the whole model. And they join up at these positions called points. When you increase resolution at options menu, you increase the number of triangles. Likewise, when you decrease the resolution, you decrease the triangles and points, and it will take less time to render your model. Let's try out each of the options, starting with extrusion. Extrusion is pretty straightforward. Decrease the value, you decrease the thickness. Increase the value, the model becomes thicker. Let's adjust the resolution. Let me lower the resolution. You can see the triangles grow in size with less points. And when I increase the resolution, the triangles become denser. Let's change the bevel from 0 to 24. This chamfers the edges instead of coming down at a sharp 90 degree angle. Bear in mind, the higher the value of chamfer, the thicker your model grows sideways. In other words, the logo becomes fat, and it's no longer your logo. It's a fat logo. You can adjust the resolution of your bevel if you need to with this slider. The higher the number equates the number of division line on your bevel. I adjusted to 6, so there are 6 lines within my bevel edges. Next, let's check out curvature of the bevel. Let's decrease the value, creating a concave bevel. Increasing the value gives the bevel a more rounded, cute look. Turn off polyframe. And we're done. Let's say we want to turn this into a tool so that we can load it every time we open up a new project. Click on Save As under Tool. And then go to and change the name, whatever name you want. I'll call it sample logo. And then we're going to close this file. Do you want to save ZBrush project? No. So when I open it up, I can load the logo as a tool. Under tool, click on load tool. And then click on the sample logo and open. And it will be loaded into your tool library. Once you've loaded the sample logo, you can now click on your canvas and use your logo whenever you need to. And that's it. And if you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and click on subscribe so that you won't miss any future videos I'll be uploading. See you.